guys, welcome to my Save the Cats series, where I am going over the 15 beats in Save the Cats during the entire month of November. Today's video is the break into two, because we are heading into Act Two. I've already gone over the 5 beats in Act One. The playlist to those videos will be in the description box below for you guys to check out. So the first part in Act Two is the break into two. And what exactly does that mean? This is where your character enters the upside down world. This is where they go about fixing their entire problem the wrong way. So the first thing you need to know about the break into two is that this is the part where you make it apparent to your reader that you are no longer in Kansas, like the book says. They have entered into a new world. Everything is completely different than what you created in Act One. The next thing you need to know is that they don't necessarily need to go anywhere for this world to be different. It could just be a new relationship, a new job, a new approach to a situation. It just has to be different. It has to be upside down to whatever you created in Act One. The next thing you need to know about the break into two is that if the debate was all about should I do this? How should I do this? Why should I do this? The break into two is I should do this and I will do this. Next, you need to know that they are going to be motivated by the wrong thing. At this point, they are still trying to fix their problem the wrong way. They haven't learned your theme and they're not even close to it yet. And finally, not only are they motivated by the wrong thing, but they are trying to fix the wrong thing. So what I wanted to mention about the beats is that before we get into the beats in the story, the author has created a bunch of exercises for us to get to know our characters and their flaws and their motivations, and just to get to know them a little bit more before we actually get into outlining our story per the beats. So for example, where you are going to ask yourself, what is it that my character, what is my character's problem in this story, right? What is their main problem? You're going to know what the problem is, the true problem, but you're also going to create a problem that they think they have, and that is what they are motivated by. That is what they are trying to fix. So that is why I think it's important for you to get the book, because you can answer a ton of these questions before you even get to this part, and it's easier for you to write scenes that follow that motivation. So for example, the book that I'm writing now, my character doesn't believe in love. She is jaded by love. She doesn't want anything to do with it. But despite that, she still fell in love. So her problem now is that she doesn't know how to get over this guy. So instead of going with the flow and living a life with this guy, she has created this wall that she doesn't want anything to do with love. So what I've done is I've created different scenes that put her in a place where she's motivated to get over him. Her motivation is to not love him, to get over him as soon as she can, and to just be free of this emotion that she feels that she can't get over. So I've created a bunch of different scenes for her to chase that motive, that motivation, and it's not going to probably end well for her, but that is the whole point of what you are creating for your character. So that is what you need to do, is create a ton of scenes for your character to be chasing the wrong thing, the thing that they think is going to fix them. Okay, you guys, that is it for the break into two. Remember to go back and watch the first 5 beats in Act One so that you are up to date with everything that's going on. As always, I will be posting a video every other day for the entire month of November until we get to the last beat, the 15th beat, which is going to be on November 30th. If you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so that you don't miss all the videos that I have coming your way. Until next time, stay safe.